Senator Ronald De La Rosa will refile a bill to make ROTC, or the Reserve Officers Training Corps, mandatory. De La Rosa argues the youth should have basic military training to help defend the country amid threats from China in the West Philippine Sea.
So, sabi ko nga sa kabataan ngayon, alam nyo, patriotism, yung pagdidepensa sa ating bansa, ay hindi mo yung makukuha being a keyboard warrior. You have to be a true warrior in order to defend this country from foreign aggression.
De La Rosa also notes he is aware of issues that hounded ROTC in the past. He says these will be addressed in the bill that he will file in the upcoming 19th Congress. ROTC, which was a mandatory military training in college, was made optional in 2002 following an alleged killing of a student by course officers. For a teacher's group, there are other ways to teach patriotism and discipline other than military training.
Bago pa natin pag-usapan itong mandatory military training, no? Bakit hindi natin na pagtuunan ng pansin yung pagtuturo po ng basic human rights, no? Ng rule of law, discipline po yan ang pinag-uusapan dyan. Ano po, Philippine history, no? Yung ating pong kultura, yung ating values, ano po, discipline po pinag-uusapan dyan, civic duties, ano.
Philippine authorities seeking ways to accelerate the process of deployment of overseas Filipino workers. The chief of the Philippine Overseas Employment Administration says this is one of the marching orders of incoming Migrant Workers Secretary Susan Ople. The POEA will be under the relatively new Migrant Workers Department once the agency is fully constituted.
Tinitignan po natin dito yung efficiency of the delivery of services to our OFWs ay napaka-importante. Kaya yung pong ease of doing business, yan po ang kasalukuyang pinagtutuunan natin ng pansin. Kung paano mapapadali ang mga proseso, lalong-lalo na sa pag-aaproba ng mga prosesong mga dokumento.
Attorney Bernard Olalia also notes OFW deployments are slowly recovering, especially in the seafaring industry. Deployments fell by up to 74% in 2020 due to the COVID pandemic.
Outgoing President Rodrigo Duterte graces the oath-taking of his son, Davao City Mayor-elect Sebastian Duterte. The ceremony is conducted at the Session Hall of Davao City Council Monday. Aside from the younger Duterte, other local officials in Davao City also took their oath. During his speech, the president boasted about his crackdown against oligarchs during his administration.
Justice Secretary Minardo Guevara says International Criminal Court prosecutor Karim Khan should have given the government more time to investigate the Duterte administration's bloody war on drugs. According to Guevara, a probe of this magnitude and complexity cannot be finished in a few months. Khan had made a request to the ICC pretrial chamber to resume his investigation, saying the Philippine government has not demonstrated it has investigated or is investigating alleged crimes committed in the drug war. His probe was halted in November last year upon the request of the Philippine government to conduct its own review. But so far, the government has only released a matrix of 52 drug war-related cases out of hundreds, and only a handful have reached the courts.
A senior expert at the International Center for Transitional Justice says it's only right for the ICC prosecutor to resume his probe into the Duterte administration's war on drugs. Ruben Carranza points out the Philippine government already had about 8 months to substantiate its request to defer the investigation when it only originally asked for 3 months. Carranza also backing Prosecutor Khan's view that Manila's actions do not mirror the kind of drug war investigation the ICC would conduct.
None of these documents showed an ongoing criminal investigation that leads to prosecution. As a matter of fact, the Philippine government submitted documents relating to writs of amparo cases filed before the Supreme Court filed by victims and their families and by human rights lawyers to protect those survivors of extrajudicial killings or their family members. These were not filed by the Philippine government. And I can't believe the gall of Philippine government officials invoking writs of amparo sought by victims and survivors against police and death squads as basis to defer. One of the more important points too is the fact that the Philippine government did not submit a single document that shows there is an investigation into the 2011 to 2016 Davao extrajudicial killings.
As for the likelihood that outgoing President Duterte himself will be investigated by the ICC, here's what Carranza has to say about the matter.
It's too early to say if it makes any difference now that he's no longer president. But of course, two things to remember. His daughter is the vice president of the Philippines. And in her own right, she might also be subjected to investigation by the ICC. Because as I said earlier, the ICC investigation covers the 2011-2016 period in Davao where there were killings when both father and daughter took turns being mayor. But of course, being the vice president makes her powerful. The incoming administration has indicated that it won't cooperate with the ICC. It won't go back to the ICC as a state party.
Attorney Christina Conti, the counsel for some of the victims of Duterte's drug war, says the ICC probe is a vindication for the victims and their families. Conti also recognizes the efforts of the Philippine Justice Department to investigate Duterte's drug crackdown. But she said those efforts were simply not enough.
I think Secretary Minardo Guevara has made valiant efforts at showing that the Philippines is investigating. However, I really feel that he's alone in pursuing these accountability measures. Any investigation should have started the first time the first killing started, and that was in 2016. The ICC investigation, preliminary probe, actually began in February 2018. But the Philippine government chose to overlook these signs, chose to just stay mum, and only proceeded in June 2020. In any case, clearly this review by the DOJ is too little and too late.
The Integrated Bar of the Philippines, meanwhile, says the possible reopening of the ICC probe may shed light on the atrocities committed in the guise of the drug war.
Kasi ang purpose naman ng investigation is to reach the truth, no? Ang katotohanan. Meron ba talagang mga nangyaring krimen na tinatawag na crimes against humanity? Yun po yung importante na may karapatan yung tao ng yung Pilipinong malaman.